But because of what? They think because of the condition and the mindset that we have. And we can do much more than we are doing at the moment. And that is the key reason why we have Afrima, why Afrima was established. It's a communication tool. We are using the power, the star power of our superstars. We are using the power of music to communicate the beauty, the glamour, the positive side of this continent to the rest of the world for global competitiveness. That's what we are doing. And that's what informs our clear-cut values. We call it FACES: fairness, authenticity, creativity, excellence, integrity, and transparency. Well, we ensure that anything we do excellently well because we are communicating ourselves to the rest of the world. And we ensure that everybody is included in this movement. Be that as it may, by the power conferred on me as the president and executive of Afrima, I'm flowing from unveiling of the Republic of Ghana as the host country for Afrima, 5th Afrima 2018. I hereby announce to the rest of the world, to the gentlemen of the press, to the music industry in Ghana, and to the government of the Republic of Ghana, and to the professionals in the music industry, that Ghana is the host country for all African music awards. Thank you for having me. For us to move forward, I just claim your indulgence for those 5 minutes so that you understand our journey thus far. And for some of us that have not had the privilege of attending Afrima, with the 5 minutes clip that we're going to play, I hope we have heard you. Just understand the journey thus far and what Afrima is all about. And after that, I'll go to when is Afrima, what are the events are we expected to see during the Afrima event. Then I'll close my statement. Thank you. Can we have a video, please? I'll start off.
I'm telling you, 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 And the fact that you are using your platform also to say something about the conditions and the context of some of the major issues of the United States.
To the rest of the world, that this is how we want to be communicated or addressed. And that is what Afrima stands for. So what's going to happen in November? The event is going to be 21, it'll be scheduled to hold 21st to 24th of November in Ghana. And the first event is 21, is what we call Welcome Soiree. That is when the people of Ghana will show the hospitality they are known for to the delegations that will be coming, attending the event from 21. And then on the 22nd, we have what we call African Music Business Summit, like my colleague earlier stated. This is where we discuss the business of music. How can we take more people away from the street through music? How can we empower our people even more? How can we enrich our people even more? You know, many of our artists, they live famous, but it's very unfortunate that when they die in poverty. They start begging and looking for money to do their very, and it's very embarrassing to us. And we're taking advantage of technology to ensure that our people get what they desire. So IP issues, we bring policy makers, we bring industry players, and it's a forum for networking, for building career and capacity of our artists. So no artist should miss this, no artist manager should miss this opportunity in Kerala, bringing players across the world to ensure that our people can benefit from this venture. That's the morning of 22nd. It's run from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. on the 22nd, which is a Thursday. On the evening of that 22nd, we have what we call Afrima Music Village. The Music Village, because Afrima is about the people of the continent, many of our people may not have enough money to buy tickets or what to see Kid Promise or Sammy play before. But on that day, what will we do? All the biggest superstars that normally come for Afrima, we normally organize the Afrima Music Village, where people, our people, will come in thousands, up to 80,000 or 100,000. To see them perform live. And how do you get it? Just get a t-shirt of Afrima and go in. And it's just less than maybe $2-3 or $4 or $10. But I know the people in China fix it. So the idea is massive. And I hope you saw through the video some of the past Afrima music videos. So it runs from, I think last year we stopped the event at 6 a.m. because 2016. We had to stop at 7:30 a.m. So we insisted that we must stop at 6 a.m. because we still have thousands of people still are listening or enjoying themselves. Then the following day, 23rd, there's what we call City Tour. All the artists locally, and those who are coming from outside Ghana, will move around the cities, go to tourist sites in Ghana, and of course, they're just to communicate the city to the rest of the world. That there's a beautiful city, a beautiful country called Ghana, and where you have a beautiful city called Accra. Where people don't live on trees, you understand? So we need the staff power to promote that. I will move around, so we need require a camaraderie among our people and to change that single narrative about the continent. That's what it's all about. Then the following day, of course, on the evening of 23rd, we have what we call the Nominees Party. It's an industry event where you have artists, international journalists, and local journalists, and of course, our government officials interact and celebrate the superstars in Ghana. Then the following day, of course, is the award ceremony, which of course, one of the biggest part of it is the red carpet. It's huge. I'm going to close some rooms this time around in front of the International Conference Center to ensure that the red carpet is massive and everybody's accommodated. So the event of Afrima is going to be broadcast to 24 countries around the world. The award ceremony is going to be broadcast to 24 countries around the world, which means we will put up our best as Africans. Because at the end of the day, it's about people. So this is what will happen on the venue. And in conclusion, I want to solicit our support to make it work. And I know Ghana has been very fortunate to have a very dynamic, energetic, young at heart, a go-getter as a Minister of Tourism. She doesn't give up. In fact, can you ever give her a hand? Yes, and with our beautiful team, whether she's around or she's not around, there was a time she was not around, the Devil's Minister stepped in and said, which letter do you people need? We'll send it to you. Don't worry. They sent one, and you said, no, you have to write it. That's not the way to do it. We want to send a contact. Letter, 6 hours, another one landed. You understand? If not for them, it would have been a different story. You understand? But they went ahead to say, if this Ghana must have it, and this is Ghana's time to have it. Thank you for your doggedness. It's on this note I'll call for support of the artists in Ghana, members of the music industry in Ghana, gentlemen of the press in Ghana, officials of government in Ghana, the people of Ghana. You have shown Afrima and the continent a lot of love since Amir, we had our first event here. And I know it's not going to be different, but what I'm asking for as Oliver Twist is to appeal to you to up the scale and increase it. So at the end of the day, people can say, wow, this edition of Afrima is far, far better, bigger, more exhilarating and exciting than any Afrima ever. Thank you. God bless you. Okay, my colleague said that corporate Ghana will have opportunity to identify and associate with one of the biggest brands that has come out of North of Sahara and South of Liverpool. Thank you so much. Take your time back and tell.
Thank you so much, President Dada. Ladies and gentlemen, again, let me mention that we have a specific hashtag for this particular